from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Widespread outages have kept lights out not only at homes and businesses, but at schools as well, pushing back the start date of the school year in some districts. RSU 17, which is made up of Oxford and neighboring towns, was scheduled to begin its year yesterday. But the combination of 30 closed roads and a high number of outages forced them to push back the start of school until tomorrow. The superintendent of schools for MSAD 52 says there have been many factors to consider, but with power coming back in the Turner area, school is slated to start tomorrow.
We've got to ensure that we can get them here safely, that we have food products that haven't been perished or compromised by having no power in a school, and that we can get our staff in as well.
And obviously be sensitive to the kids. They want a normal setting also here, and, you know, for our staff to make sure it's a great start of the year and, you know, make sure they have that excitement and what's going on for them.
The school districts still have to determine how they want to handle the lost days. Poland will use a built-in snow day. Oxford may make an appeal to the Commissioner of Education for a waiver. And Turner will try to make it up somewhere else during the year. Well, the race is on in the Sebago Lake region as the area works to bounce back from Tropical Storm Irene in time for Labor Day weekend. Crews spent the past 2 days cleaning up the extensive damage at Sebago Lake State Park, where more than 1,000 campers are expected. And while no one seems worried about the number of visitors who will be there, some business owners say the storm has made it difficult to serve them. The owner of this restaurant lost hundreds of dollars worth of seafood and will only be able to put out ice cream on his menu when he reopens this weekend.
So it's been devastating because the last weekend, Labor Day weekend, is usually, you know, the last hurrah up here for most of the seasonal people, and it's, you know, it's money when you make the money.
When you cut the season short, you know, it just all adds up. And when you cut the season short for not just one or two customers, but 10 customers, it adds up really quick.
Sebago Lake Marina owner Charles Frechette tells News 8 that he is worried that many boat owners who haul their boats out of the water for Irene may choose not to put them back in since it is so late in the season. A tropical storm Irene has forced the Salvation Army in Old Orchard Beach to throw away most of its food supply, leaving it in dire need of donations. Workers spent much of the day tossing out frozen food and other items that spoiled because of the power outage caused by this weekend's storm. The pantry won't be getting another shipment of frozen food until mid to late September, but they say donations are needed now. Two shuttered paper mills in Millinocket and East Millinocket are getting a new start. Governor Paul LePage announced a sale agreement allowing New Hampshire-based Kate Street Capital to purchase the Katahdin Paper Company mills. The governor calls the agreement a, quote, significant milestone in the efforts to restore papermaking to the region and bring jobs to northern Maine. The Kate Street Capital says several changes have to be made before now and when the sale can be finalized in a month. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.